These policies have explicitly sought to preserve the comforts and privileges bestowed upon single-family zones by limiting multifamily developments to a small fraction of the city. This has concentrated renters in scarce multifamily areas, and the scarcity has resulted in higher cost of living and higher rates of displacement, as the land underneath these renters has increased faster than other residential zones. Why should renters bear the burden of Seattle's recent growth while homeowners continue to reap their rewards?